One example of a technique to actually improve the ILP of the program is tree height reduction. Let's consider a program that looks like this. Let's say that we need a sum of these four registers in R8. One way to get that is to add the first two numbers into R8 and then add the second number and then add the third number and then the fourth number. However, this forms a dependence chain because we have the dependence here and the dependence here, so really these instructions have to be done one after the other. So tree height reduction works as follows. The compiler figures out that instead of adding one number at a time to the sum and thus creating a chain of dependencies, what we can do is we can group the computation this way, thus getting we first add the first two numbers and put that in R8, then we add the second pair of numbers, put that in R7, and then we add up the R8 and R7 into our final result, R8. The dependencies here are this and this. So now we have two instructions that can execute in parallel with each other because they don't depend on each other, and then a third instruction that does depend on them too. So if this needed three cycles to execute, this can actually execute in two cycles if we have a processor that can do at least two instructions per cycle. Tree height reduction cannot always be done. It uses associativity of the addition operation, and you have to keep in mind that not all operations are associative. So we have to be careful. We can only do this when the final result is the same as if we did things in the proper order, let's say.